Hey Grio fam, I'm Gerren Keith Gaynor, managing editor at TheGrio, and this is Grio Top 3, powered by the Dirt Culture Podcast, which I co-host alongside Shauna Pinnick, social media director here at TheGrio. And here at Grio Top 3, we give you the top 3 trending stories of the day. Coming in at number 3, rumors are swirling that Nick Cannon is expecting his 7th child. Nick Cannon may have a lot of jobs, but lately his personal life has been keeping him busy. The actor and TV host is allegedly expecting another child this year. Rumors are swirling that Cannon is expecting a child with model Alyssa Scott. Scott appeared on the host's show Wild and Out, but recently sparked pregnancy rumors when a posted then deleted nude maternity photo of her surfaced. A user congratulated her and Cannon under the post, to which Scott replied with a thank you. Cannon has yet to confirm, but the model says she is around 34 weeks pregnant with a boy, Zen S. Cannon. Scott first announced her pregnancy in January with a post that read, quote, "Let's all gasp together. So excited, baby number 2 on the way." Although this is Scott's 2nd child, it would be Cannon's 7th child and his 3rd in a year. Cannon is also expecting twins with Abby De La Rosa. They made the announcement and debuted maternity photos in which Cannon appeared shirtless back in April. Cannon also has a set of twins, Moroccan and Monroe, 9, with his ex-wife Mariah Carey. Cannon has not confirmed he is expecting with Scott, but rumors began to swirl when he posted an image of himself holding a microphone on the street alongside a little girl. The caption of the image read, "Friends and family smiling every day, hashtag stay tuned." It looks like we all will be watching this story as it unfolds. Maybe a congratulations, maybe not. Stay tuned. Coming in at number 2, a WNBA coach is suspended for making disrespectful comments about a player's size. The WNBA announced on Monday that Connecticut Sun head coach and general manager Kurt Miller has been fined $10,000 and suspended for 1 game after criticizing the weight of Los Angeles Aces player Liz Cambage. Miller reportedly made the comment during the Suns' 72-65 win over the Aces. In a video posted on Instagram, Cambage, 29, said Miller was arguing for a call at one point during the game when he took aim at her by saying to the ref, quote, "Come on, she's 300 pounds. I will never let a man disrespect me," Cambage said in her IG post in which she called out Miller for disrespecting her. "For a coach on another team to be yelling like protected abuse because we can't do nothing back is just crazy to me," she added. Miller issued a statement on Monday in which he acknowledged that his comment was inappropriate. He also apologized to Cambage and the Aces. Speaking to reporters Monday evening, Miller admitted that he was disappointed in himself over his remarks. "As a leader, words matter. It was inappropriate," he said. "In a league where we empower women, I spent 31 years empowering women, those words were just not acceptable." Miller, meanwhile, wants you to know that she stands 6'8" and weighs 235 pounds, and she's proud of her frame. "So to the coach of Connecticut, I'm sorry, little sir man, I do not know your name," said Cambage, a 3-time All-Star in 5 WNBA seasons. "But the next time you try to call out a referee trying to get a call being like, come on, she's 300 pounds, I'm going to need you to get it right, baby. I'm weighing 235 pounds and I'm very proud of being a big B. Big body, big bends, baby. So don't ever try to disrespect me or another woman in the league." Shout out to Liz Cambage. That is how you clap back at a hater. And to Coach Miller, do better. Coming in at number 1, actress Lela Rochon's daughter goes to prom in her mom's waiting to exhale dress. The daughter of actress Lela Rochon wore a glamorous red gown that once belonged to her famous mom to her own recent senior prom. The scarlet stunner Asia Rochon Fuqua Dome was what Rochon wore for the premiere of Waiting to Exhale more than 25 years ago, and she was thrilled at how gorgeous her oh-so-grown child looked in it. Rochon shared several photos of her daughter in the dress with a caption reading, "Yes, I saved the dress, heart emoji, wasn't sure why, but now I know, hashtag vintage." She also sent out a shout out to makeup artist Adam Christopher. The actress's series of pictures also feature a side-by-side photo of herself in the gown 25 years ago and a current picture of Rochon and her daughter together. She also shared a photo of herself Asia, and her husband, director Antoine Fuqua. There was no shortage of friends or fans commenting under the post. Vivica A. Fox wrote, "Oh my God, fabulous." Gabrielle Union added, "So, so beautiful." Asia Rochon Fuqua will attend the University of Southern California this fall. Waiting to Exhale was the first film to be adapted from a book by Terry McMillan. The iconic 1995 movie star Angela Bassett, Whitney Houston, Rochon, and Loretta Devine, and followed the love lives of four friends living in Phoenix, Arizona. Directed by Forrest Whitaker, Waiting to Exhale grossed more than $80 million worldwide and won several NAACP Image Awards for both the film and the iconic soundtrack produced by Babyface. What a beautiful mommy-daughter moment, and you gotta love a moment of nostalgia. I think now I'm gonna add Waiting to Exhale to my weekend watch list. This has been Grio Top 3, powered by the Dear Culture Podcast. For more episodes, visit our YouTube page. For more stories, visit thegrio.com. And make sure you subscribe to the Dear Culture Podcast wherever you listen to your podcast. Thanks for tuning in, and see you next time.